morning. As many of you know, may know or may not know, we've been enduring these massive tidal waves here in Monta for the last week, several days, 3 or 4 days now. And they're called king tides is what they call them. They do a lot of damage. They cause a lot of beach erosion. They take a lot of the sand off of the beach. They destroy a lot of the equipment that's on the beach that the vendors use to sell their goods, their fruits, and their souvenirs. And it just really wreaks havoc on the beach. Good news about it is that it kind of rebuilds the beach for us. You know, we get these a couple times a year, if I remember right. I know that when we have king tides, especially here where I live, if you listen real closely, you can probably hear them right now. Maybe not. I don't know. But anyway, so I got an email from somebody that I want to share with you, and then I'm going to share my response as well. Hello, Mr. Shader. I suspect there is a relationship between the ongoing Kilauea volcano eruption on the Big Island of Hawaii. I don't know if I pronounced that right or not. If I did, sorry. Your waves, beach erosion in Monta, and the recent destruction of the wharf in Santa Cruz, California, by extra large waves. Perhaps there are some plates shifting under the Pacific Ocean sea floor. Then he said, do you know if Monta has ever experienced a tsunami event in the past? Then he said, I'd be grateful if you could examine the stairwell in your apartment complex with a flashlight, determine how long it takes you to descend and exit the apartment towards higher ground. All the best to you. And I'm going to say anonymous. I'm not going to reveal the source out of respect for him or her. So let me tell you what I know about this event, the king tides, okay? And just so you know, I use ChatGPT to do my research, and I'm just going to read to you what Darby provided for me. And here we go. King tides are the highest tides of the year, and they occur due to specific astronomical and gravitational conditions. Along the coast of Ecuador, these tides are influenced by the same factors that cause king tides globally. Here's what drives them. Number one, gravitational alignment of the sun and moon. Spring tides, these occur when the sun, earth, and moon align during full or new moons, causing their gravitational forces to combine and pull more strongly on Earth's oceans. Proximity of the moon. During a king tide, the moon is often at its closest point to Earth, called perigee, which intensifies its gravitational effect. And finally, the combination of these factors result in extremely high total ranges. Number two, seasonal polar position. The sun's position relative to the Earth changes throughout the year. Around the solstice, the sun's gravitational effect on the tides is slightly stronger due to the angle of the Earth. Number three, local geographical features. Ecuador's coastline, along with its shallow coastal shelves and specific topography, amplifies the tidal effects, making the king tides more pronounced. The Humboldt Current, a cold ocean current that runs along the South American coast, can also interact with tidal dynamics. And then number four, the Earth's elliptical orbit around the sun means that there are times when Earth is closer to the sun, perihelion, which enhances the sun's gravitational pull on the oceans. King tides often coincide with this phenomenon. So why are these tides an annual event in Ecuador? Ecuador's location, you know, the equator, means that its coastal regions experience consistent tidal patterns throughout the year. The interplay between the predictable cycles of the moon and sun ensures that king tides occur annually, particularly during the astral or austral summer, December to February, when solar and lunar alignments are strongest. And, you know, the effects are coastal flooding, increased erosion, and marine navigation. The low-lying areas, particularly near mangroves and the beaches, you know, can experience flooding. The higher water levels and stronger waves erode beaches and coastal infrastructure. And I've seen that. If you just look at some of my couple of my last videos that I produced from my walks on the beach, you can see the destruction that I'm talking about. And as far as marine navigation, fishermen and maritime operators must account for extreme tidal ranges. So that's what I found out, okay? And to answer the reader's question about my apartment and so forth, I'll tell you what I told him. He also, you know, he asked me about the tsunamis, and I told him, I said, I don't know that Monta has ever experienced a tsunami. We do have a tsunami warning system here, but quite frankly, I'd be surprised if it worked based on the way the infrastructure is slapped together here. You never know. And then as far as, you know, finding out, I went on to tell my apartment building is a good 50 feet above sea level, so I never think about having to head to higher ground. As far as descending the stairwell from my floor, takes about 3 minutes for 10 floors for me to get to the street level. That's about all. So anyway, that's all I wanted to tell you about this. There are lots of people that have a complete misunderstanding. I'm not saying that about this particular reader, but there are a lot of people that have a complete misunderstanding. You know, they blame it on global warming, blame it on climate change, blame it on Trump, blame it on Obama, the Bidens, whatever, okay? Factually speaking, it has more to do with the sun and the moon and the earth and the alignments and the fact that we're here on the, you know, on the equator than any of that other garbage talk stuff, social media crap, okay? Thank you for listening. See you on the next one. Ciao, ciao.